Good morning, everyone. This is my second presentation. The title is Central Retinal Thickness Changes in PDR Patients Treated with Intravitreal Ranibizumab and Ranibizumab with PRP. There are no financial disclosures for the study. Coming to introduction, diabetic retinopathy is a common complication of type 2 diabetes and is a leading cause of blindness in the working population in the world. Without timely treatment, 50% of the patients with proliferative diabetic retinopathy will lose their sight within 5 years. Retinal neovascularization represents an important risk factor for severe vision loss in patients with diabetic mellitus. Pan-retinal photocoagulation has been a gold standard for PDR treatment since 1980s as it arrests the progression of diabetic retinopathy by improving retinal oxygen supply and decreasing the subsequent production of vascular endothelial growth factors. Anti-VEGF intravitreal therapies radically change the outcome of DR due to combined anti-angiogenic and anti-edematous activities. Coming to the aim of the study, to compare central retinal thickness between eyes with proliferative diabetic retinopathy treated with intravitreal ranibizumab and intravitreal ranibizumab with pan-retinal photocoagulation. Coming to objectives of my study, it is to assess the changes in central retinal thickness in patients with PDR undergoing intravitreal ranibizumab and intravitreal ranibizumab with PRP and to compare the changes between these two groups. Coming to the study type, mine is a prospective observational study taking 30 eyes which are coming to the OPD, which were divided into 15 eyes in group A and 15 eyes into group B. Group A were given intravitreal ranibizumab and group B were given intravitreal ranibizumab along with PRP. It was a convenient sampling and the duration of study is 6 months. All the demographic details were collected and the study was in accordance with ethical committee guidelines. All the patients were informed about the purpose of the study and an informed consent was obtained. Institutional review board clearance was taken for the study. Coming to methodology, best corrected visual acuity in logMAR format was recorded and IOP by Goldman Appellation tonometry was done. Pupillary dilatation was done with 1% tropicamide eye drops after checking IOP. Dilated fundus examination with a direct ophthalmoscope plus 90 lens and in case of media haziness, an indirect ophthalmoscopy was done in these patients. On fundus, diabetic retinopathy severity was graded using EDTRS protocol and a basic blood investigations like RVS and HbA1c were taken. Coming to the procedure of the study, the first group received intravitreal ranibizumab of 0.5 mg in 0.05 ml at baseline 4 weeks and 8 weeks. The second group received standard PRP treatment delivered as per routine clinical practice targeting non-perfusion areas along with intravitreal ranibizumab. PRP was performed using a single retinal specialist with NIDA green laser of 532 nanometers frequency. PRP was performed in 2 sessions with an interval of 15 days between the session and shots were delivered with a pulse duration of 0.2 seconds for a total of 1200 to 2000 burns. SDOCT was performed measuring central retinal thickness. Coming to inclusion criteria, patients with proliferative diabetic retinopathy defined as per EDTRS guidelines as follows: presence of neovascularization at the disc, presence of NVD associated with vitreous or pre-retinal hemorrhages, and neovascularization elsewhere with more than half disc area associated with vitreous or pre-retinal hemorrhages. And coming to exclusion criteria, patients with significant medial opacity, history of prior laser treatment or vitrectomy in the study eye, tractional retinal detachment, and patients with histories of ophthalmic diseases other than diabetic retinopathy and cataract, patients with intraocular surgeries except for cataract extraction, and patients with external ocular infections like conjunctivitis, keratitis, or significant blepharitis were excluded. Coming to data analysis, the collected data was analyzed using Microsoft Excel and SPSS version, and statistical analysis was independent sample t-test and p-value less than 0.05 was taken as significant. Coming to my results, both group A and group B, independently both the results were significant with mean in group A taken as 0.56 plus or minus 0.15 after 1 month with a confidence interval of 0.48 to 0.64 and in group B 0.53 plus or minus with 0.14 and confidence interval of 0.45 to 0.61. Even central retinal thickness was significant after 1 month. Independently. Coming to discussion, when compared with the other group of studies, in Philpa et al., pan-retinal photocoagulation versus PRP plus intravitreal ranibizumab for high-risk proliferative diabetic retinopathy, where 40 patients were taken, and they concluded that intravitreal ranibizumab after PRP was associated with larger reduction in FLP at a week 48 compared with PRP alone in the eyes with high-risk PDR. And adjunctive use of IVR appears to protect against the modest visual acuity loss and macular swelling observed in eyes treated with PRP alone. coming to Filgro et al., ranibizumab plus RPRP versus PRP alone for high-risk proliferative diabetic retinopathy called Proteus study was done in 87 patients, and they concluded that intravitreal ranibizumab along with PRP was more effective than PRP monotherapy for neovascularization regression in high-risk PDR patients over 12 months. The limitations of my study was a shorter follow-up time period, and the conclusion is that intravitreal ranibizumab along with PRP was associated with larger reduction in central retinal thickness at 1 month when compared with intravitreal ranibizumab alone in patients with PDR. The additional use of PRP appears to protect against the visual function than intravitreal ranibizumab alone. Here are my references. Thank you.
Cases did you find with opaque media? Question number one. Because when you start using the PDR, patient may have vitreous hemorrhage, patient may have TRD. So no, there must be large number of cases which can be were excluded.
There are so many of
associated complications. Number two, you are working opposite the school of thought where PRP causes macular edema. So here you are proving something that PRP reduces the macular edema.
Yes, sir.
So you have to think about this.
Okay, sir. Thank you.